Hello, my name is Tony Chan for TelecomTV. I'm here at the OpenStack Summit in Sydney, Australia. With me today is Bin Hu, who's acting as an ambassador for the OPNFV initiative. Bin, great to have you here today. Since we're here at the OpenStack Summit, can you just give a little bit of background how OpenStack actually relates to OPNFV?
Okay. OPNFV stands for Open Platform for Network Function Virtualization. And the OPNFV is uniquely positioned to facilitate the deployment and the development of the OPNFV components across various upstream projects. And one of the upstream projects is OpenStack. And imagine the overall architecture of the OPNFV platform. It has different layers. And at the bottom layer, above the operating system, it is a virtualized infrastructure manager called Vim, which manages the infrastructure itself, including the compute, storage, and networking. And OpenStack is one of the platform and which is primarily in the market manage the infrastructure we call the VIN layer. And on top of the VIN layer, there are different the other layers, including the networking SD controllers, including the Kubernetes and orchestration layers. So OPNFV integrate all those upstream projects, including the ODL, including the owners and OpenStack, and provide through its integration and testing and deployment, and create a reference MV platform so that end users will be able to create new services and products on top of that platform.
You talked about services and products. What are some of these benefits for operators when they're actually rolling out and implementing something like OPNFV and OpenStack?
Yeah, so operators is end users of the MV platform. And the unique challenges for the operators is the agility in terms of developing and deploying and new service products. And the OPNFV and OpenStack, by those integration, uniquely provides a method to support the agile development of the product services, as well as a method of operating those services. So in that meaning, so it will help operators to reduce the return on reinvestment and improve the return on reinvestment, but reduce the capex and reduce the opex. So basically, decrease the overall total cost of ownership and improve the return on investment.
You talked about services. Do you have any use cases that you can describe for operators that have rolled out OPNFV?
And for example, and we are talking about 5G, we are talking about the IMS. So all those different virtual functions, like a virtual IMS, virtual EPC, and even in the 5G world, all those services could be rolled out as a virtual functions on top of the OPNFV platform. And with the support of the different virtualization technologies, such as the VMs by OpenStack or the containers by the Kubernetes, and with the virtual networking technologies from the provided by the Open Daylight, from the owners, or from the Open Control. And so all those supporting put together supports the new services that will be rolled out by the different operators, especially in the 5G stage.
You mentioned the fact that OPNFV is well positioned to help operators adopt this new software-defined architecture. What do you think your principal role is in helping them like rapidly roll out or adopt these services?
Operators basically is end users, right? And whatever is delivered by OPNFV and needs the users to be able to use that the type of the products. So we have to make sure that OPNFV deliverables meets the needs of the end user. And so operators' role there as end user, operators has different roles. And first provides a requirement use case. And that requirement use case will be translated into the specific tasks for the different deliverables at different releases for the platform. And then operators can also help in the testing and acceptance of the deliverables. And for example, operating will be able to actively participate in the system level testing, in the integration testing, in the platform performance testing, and in the user acceptance testing of the platform itself. And the operators in the OPNFV community is very active. For example, Orange is the has been put lots of resources in the testing projects in order for the OPNFV to be able to have a platform to be delivered after the well-tested the services.
Right, okay. One of the big trends today and going forward towards 5G is something called multi-edge, multi-access edge computing.
That's right.
How does OPNFV handle this? And are you changing systems or adopting projects for this architecture?
Yeah, OPNFV, and because OPNFV is an integration project, and its position is just like a bridge to connecting the MANO layer and infrastructure layer. So MANO stands for management and network orchestration. So it basically, it supports some functions like a VNF onboarding, application management, and orchestration. And so once the MANO dispatches the applications, right, those VNFs needs to be deployed on the different infrastructure. And the OPNFV is positioned to help deploying those VNF applications through the different infrastructures. For example, in the ONAP is an orchestration project in the Nordic Foundation. And ONAP has a multi-VIN layer. A multi-layer will be able to connect in with OPNFV and deploy the workloads and even the platform itself and through OPNFV and to the all the different type of infrastructures and manages the different clouds, including the edge cloud, including the hyperscale data centers, and including those core data centers and on the operator side.
Moving forward to 5G, does OPNFV have any specific projects or initiatives that is focus on upcoming 5G services?
So 5G, and from 5G perspective, and there are different layers in terms of virtualizing the different 5G nodes like e-node, et cetera, et cetera. And OPNFV is actively looking for a lightweight platform to manage the infrastructure in order to support the unique characteristics in terms of the edge cloud for 5G. For example, from the edge cloud perspective, and the hardware resource limitations, footprints, is a critical factor for the success of the edge computing. And another success factor includes the network latency, and also includes the intermittent network connections. And OPNFV is looking at the lightweight of using the VIM layers to support those characteristics in the from the infrastructure perspective. For example, what are the lightweight OpenStack could be deployed and integrated with OPNFV, and whether or not the container orchestration environment like Kubernetes will be able to be deployed with a bare metal and to support the edge devices. So all those areas OPNFV is actively looking at. For example, in the most recent UFRedit release in the OPNFV, and OPNFV already started the exploration of a containerized VNF and integrating the Kubernetes with the bare metal and SDN controllers as an early stage of experiment at this moment.
The industry is expecting 5G to be ready as early as next year, maybe 2019. Uh-huh. Will OPNFV be ready for that?
I would say market needs is our goal. So the whole community is looking at what's the priorities from the market perspective and what's the most important part for the next release of OPNFV. And so from community perspective, once we listen to the operator's requirement, once we listen to those use case, and OPNFV will appropriately position and to allocate the necessary resources to support the need for the market.
Great. Thank you very much, Ben.
Okay, thank you, Tony.